Optics is a new collection of professional plugins for Photoshop from Boris Effects. In this quick start video, I will show you how to dive into the Optics interface and get started adding amazing visual effects and looks to your photos. Optics is a set of cinematic optical camera filters that emulate lighting gels, lens polarizing filters, real-world lighting effects, beauty passes, and gobo effects. Optics can recreate conditions that don't exist in the photo, like lighting from windows, lighting changes, adding environmental elements like mist or moons, and much more. Bring beautiful VFX tools to your photography in just a few clicks. First, let's talk about how it works and the user interface. I will convert my clip for smart filters, then apply Optics under the Effects menu. Optics supports Adobe Photoshop and Lightroom, and also comes with a standalone application for Mac OS and Windows. To start in Photoshop, I'll select my layer under Filters and add Boris Effects Optics. For Lightroom Classic, right-click on a picture in the library and select Edit In. Then select Boris Effects Optics. Once the filter is applied, use Edit a Copy with Lightroom Adjustments instead of saving over the original. Or in the standalone application, we'll launch and open an image under the File menu. In the top left of the Optics interface, we have a few tools that you need to know about. Reset, Crop, and Rotate, which are available in the standalone, and Add Mask, which is available in both the standalone and the plugin. And underneath that, you can find the Effects panel. The Effects panel is where you can view and affect your effects. You can find Zoom, Pan, Resolution, Compare, Snapshot, Show Mask, and Histogram at the top of the viewer. At the bottom of the viewer is the effects list with a built-in search bar. And to the far right is the Presets and Parameters panel with another search built in to navigate presets. We will get into the nitty-gritty of what these tools do in a moment. You can change the layout to suit your preferences, but we will be using the default layout in this quick start guide. Double-clicking on a thumbnail in the Presets window automatically adds the filter to an image in the viewer as well as a layer in the Effect window. Or, click on the Add Layer icon at the top left of the Effect window to add the filter as a layer. Additional filters can then be stacked the exact same way. And once you've added your filters, you can blend them using blend modes, or you can mask them, and I'll talk about masking here in a minute. You can also click on the screen icon and view that layer while working on an effect on a different layer. Optics has 75 curated Emmy-award winning Boris Effects Sapphire filters, 160 total filters, and thousands of presets. While that sounds like a lot of filters, the Search Effects feature in the bottom left is useful for finding lots of effects quickly. Like blurs, for instance. If I type blur here in this search window, I can quickly find the best blur for my shot. And the great thing about Optics is that presets look good immediately without much work. The Effects window shows all the filters that have been applied to your image. The most recently applied filter is at the top of the stack, while the earlier applications are at the bottom. When you click on a thumbnail, the viewer displays that layer. The search in the presets lets me find presets within that effect, or I can simply star my favorites. Either presets or parameters are selectable in a tab at the bottom of the window. Optics uses layers that you can manipulate individually even while viewing other layers. The interface is fairly standard and allows for preferential rearranging. Dragging masks to a different layer is a fast way to copy them from one layer to another. Simply drag the layers around in the layer pile and select the effects or masks as needed. Optics has truly excellent masking tools to selectively determine where the effects will be applied on your image. A gradient or spot mask is a black and white mask where the white is opaque and the black is transparent, and this is great for vignettes and blurs. Here, you can see that the blur is only happening within the gradient mask. While effects can be expediently applied with the gradient and X-spline masking, where optics really shines are quick mask and edge snapping splines, which both use a keep in and hold out scribble approach to determining what to grab. Snap is an easy to use interactive image masking tool. Snap provides instant visual feedback by snapping to an editable spline to an object's boundary even on low contrast edges. Using Mark Foreground, first mark an area of the image to be selected and then refine the boundary by telling Snap what not to select by using Mark Background. You can further refine an edge by either clicking and dragging spline points to edit or drawing a stroke along the edge. Easy Mask is an easy-to-use interactive masking tool capable of isolating almost any object in an image, even if you are dealing with fine hair detail, smoke, or reflections, which honestly seemed a bit like witchcraft to me the first time I used it. So we tell Easy Mask what the foreground is using Paint Foreground, and then define the background with Paint Background. Anything unknown and tricky, like hair edges or transparency, can be painted with the Paint Missing brush. Make sure to grab all of the colors present in the foreground and background respectively with strokes, or the algorithm, no matter how clever, will have trouble processing the difference between the two. You can also use the fills instead of strokes for a faster and more accurate mask. Click Create Mask, and you'll have a very articulated mask based on the estimated transparency of the object. Sometimes complicated foreground details may be missing after the mask is generated, but using the Paint Missing brush can recover lost detail. This works best when the colors between the object and the background are different enough to be keyed. The Selective Color Selection Mask is also excellent, especially for grabbing gradients of color like clouds or solid areas of color like skies, buildings, and ground planes. It uses either hue, saturation, brightness, or all of the available color channels individually or together to define a mask based on a quick stroke selection. You can then use the histogram tools to manipulate the values for the perfect mask. To create a spline path, select the Path tool from the Add Mask drop-down menu. Simply click to create a connect-the-dot path between clicks like a standard selection tool, and this will create a spline mask you can manipulate however you like. And you can, of course, paint your own mask manually by using the Paint Mask. Users can utilize selection masking and blending modes, and also move masks around between layers for fine control over every filter used. And when using the plugin, Optics expresses itself as a smart filter, so you can always fiddle with your applied effect after you have clicked Done in the plugin. To learn more about the powerful newest addition to our Boris Effects toolset, Optics, please visit us at www.boriseffects.com, where you can find free training videos, official documentation, Boris Effects news, artist interviews, case studies, and so much more.